Nowadays, I just see it, then I grab it. Make my worries disappear like magic. Trying to get it any way that I can have it. Left the fuck shit alone and turned up. That nigga Malcolm disappeared, that's the word, bruh. Now I peeped the scoreboard, seen it was a losing score. Talented, sharp black nigga, what the fuck I'm losing for? No, I got
neighborhood drug dealer, MX Dub. You know nobody keep it realer. But when I'm on the mic, they call me Showtime, like the Lakers in the late 80s. We'll leave it right there, but I used to make babies. But on all seriousness, man, it's family first over everything.
Family first.
Entertainment.
Family first, baby.
Family first. Family first.
Everybody keep the family first. So let me go ahead and introduce everybody that's rocking with the cause. We got Lonnie, bro. Lonnie B. Say what's up to the people.
What's going on? It's Lonnie B. Lonnie Bravo. I'm gonna have a new meaning for the B every time. But right now it's Lonnie B. Lonnie Bravo.
This nigga role is just to look like Chad Johnson and type on the computer. All right? Family first, though. Like I said, it's family first. So, you know, we brought Uncle Greg in the house. Uncle Greg, say what up, man.
What's going on, family? What's going on? Family first. We're about to make a movement, man. We're about to move in these streets.
You know.
You know, black don't crack, and Uncle Greg is a perfect example of that.
Hey, that's exactly why we call you Ghost. He said, we about to move in these streets.
Yeah, a.k.a. Ghost.
You know what I meant with you.
Ghost, baby. That's Ghost.
Uncle Greg, a.k.a. Ghost, a.k.a. Black Stealth. We don't know when he's going to show up or when he's going to disappear, but it's always by itself.
How you
doing? Respect.
And then we got the founder in the house. We got... I don't know if he a Cassidy clone, or if he want to be P. Diddy, or if he want to be a trainer. He ain't got no kind of license to be training nobody in no states, cities, counties, or federal.
Hey, provinces, nigga.
But I'll tell you what, though.
Got on the move training facility. Never in the same place.
Yeah. Come get him. But nah, in all seriousness, though, man, the man smoother than mashed potatoes, man. It's J. Phil, J. Diddy. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Yeah, you just heard what he says. J. Phil, a.k.a. J. Diddy, J. Phil, whatever you want to call me, as long as you put Phil in it, baby. We here, family first. Family first.
Mm-hmm. So that's everybody that's rocking with the cause now. We Army strong, so we pulling up like 100 deep. So everybody else is on standby right now, but believe me, they're in existence. But we here, family first. We here to give back to the community. We here to strengthen Arizona. We here to grow and expand. We throwing big words out because we got extensive vocabulary and we intellectual individuals, but we ignorant at the same time.
Respect.
Exactly.
Respect.
But we here to have some fun, you feel me? And
exactly.
Like I said, we here to give back. This podcast is going to be centered around a giveaway. We're giving away some Beats headphones, Beats by Dre. You know what it sounds like when you got some Beats by Dre? It sounds like sex, man. Sex. All right, we're giving away a $100 gift card to Foot Locker. A lot of y'all feet game ain't right. A lot of y'all feet game is right. Either way, we here to multiply, add, subtract, divide, whatever we do.
And if the 100 ain't enough, we better bring extra.
You want some tax?
Bring some tax. No tax on this motherfucker.
Extra 20.
No, you want some Jordans?
We'll get you started.
Yeah. You gotta finish.
But we got that, and third gift gonna be a surprise. But I'll give you this little hint. It's gonna change your world. Remember, I said that the third gift is gonna change your world. You gonna hold me to my word, cause word is bond, son. Like I come from Brooklyn.
He said something serious. Everybody got quiet. Everybody got quiet.
I thought deeper than
everybody
that.
Got quiet.
Hey, I'm trying to figure out how I could win.
It's gonna change your world.
What's the rules? Do we gotta be family?
It's gonna change your reality. Yeah, no pun intended.
Respect.
But like I said, we're here to give back. It's not just gifts, it's a contest. Okay, so you listen, and we're going to ask you some questions afterwards, just like the radio. Except for unlike the radio, we ain't giving away Bone Thugs and Harmony tickets. And no disrespect, because I love Bone Thugs and Harmony.
In the 90s.
It's the first of the month every day.
We all miss our Uncle Charles.
Yeah. Miss Uncle Charles. Yeah. Only line that nigga remember. Rest in peace, Uncle Charles. But I'm saying. We're giving away the Hey, shout out to Clarence too. But
rest in peace.
We're here to give back. We want to strengthen our ties in the community. Everybody acting like Arizona ain't part of the map, so we about to put it on the map.
On the flip side, we got a special guest, but I'm gonna let my man Jay Felt introduce him because Jay Felt be training him and stretching his legs.
Everything. If you don't know, if you're not from Arizona, he's Mr. Everything. Peoria High School. Originally came from Arizona Rising Suns, then to Peoria High School, which he did everything. So we're gonna start off with Peoria. So we got Jamal Miles, Mr. 32. So we just gonna ask him a couple questions. So when you first went to Peoria, what was your mission as an athlete?
Man, my mission was to come in and be the best at everything that I did.
Okay, so when you got there, was the talent different from Pop Warner, or was the same and you kind of just rolled into it?
Talent was a little bit more competitive. You know, you had people that was a little bit older than what you used to running against or competing against. So going in, it was just looking up to the older people and just trying to be better and do what they were doing.
Okay. Respect. So now, let everybody know, what's the main reason you went to Peoria?
Man, my main reason for going to Peoria was...
It was a good place to get stranded.
Growing up, I was ran for the Rising Suns, and my whole Rising Suns team went to Peoria, so I decided to go there because my track coach is there, and I thought it would be the best opportunity for me.
I have a question. So for people who don't know what the Rising Suns is, what is the Rising Suns? Because they might think that's anything. You know what
Rising Suns is a club track team for the USATF.
USATF.
USA Track and Field.
Yeah,
USA.
Okay.
It's a Junior Olympics.
So it's a club team. You have to pay to play, or?
Yeah, you
got to
pay to play.
Okay.
You
look like a fast nigga.
So that's a lot of people. Yeah, you know you're fast if you pay to play.
You play the run.
I'm sure I can do this. Here's $1,000.
Your mama ain't going to pay $1,000. You getting dusted. You got to do something.
So you paid to play for Rising Suns, and you started from there. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but you know most people probably don't know what that is.
Yeah. So
I wasn't going to say that.
Yeah. So that's the Rising Sun. So from then on, when did you start taking your career serious in high school? What year? Sophomore, junior year?
I took it serious soon. I stepped on the scene. You know, everything was just growing up, watching all my older peers, you know, all my cousins, and everybody, my teammates that I used to compete with, just going out there and doing their thing. So I just wanted to be as good as them.
Okay. Now, we know that Marquise Flowers, he's another one that ran with the Rising Suns. He also plays for the Bengals, number 52. Am I correct? 53. They all actually ran together. You played him at Millennium. What was that like playing against him?
It was fun playing against him because, you know, he's growing up.
Yeah.
So always competitive.
Yeah,
now I see y'all niggas get down in the U of A versus ASU game, bro. Ooh, I think it was 2011 or 2012, bro. Okay, y'all niggas was actually getting after it. Low key didn't look like y'all knew each other.
Yeah.
And shout out to Marquise Flowers. Yeah, but it looked like y'all never met each other mamas.
Hey, the field, when you play,
it just changes.
Yeah, exactly. You'll be afraid off the field, but when it's on the field, it's all business.
That's how you do it, man.
That's cool. So now, we going into, actually, you went to Peoria. Clap was everybody knows Clap in high school. Mm-hmm. How was it playing for Clap?
Playing for Clap? It's pretty cool.
Is that a coach?
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
That sounds like STD, man.
He playing for himself.
Everybody knew Clap after high school.
Yeah. Clap was actually, so for those of you that don't know, Clap was actually a high school coach. He was a high school head coach for Peoria, and he was actually the offense coordinator. Was he the offense coordinator?
He was everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
He was everything.
Everybody in Arizona know Coach Clapp.
Yeah.
I don't even know if it's for football.
Yeah.
Everybody
knows. Yeah. What do you do? It's a lot of, we ain't going to go into that.
Might be legal ramifications.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Coach Clapp was out there.
Yeah.
No problem.
But Coach Clapp was out there.
So, how did you like playing for? This is something they may not know. I'm going to put them on game. What was his favorite terminology? What was his favorite word when he ran behind you? What did he say? Let them know. What did he say?
Get out.
So
he said what?
Get out. So we're gonna give you the history. Coach Sebastian is African. He's from Nigeria, correct? Okay. Quote me if I'm wrong. Yeah. He's from Nigeria. And he was fast. He actually ran in the Olympics. So I actually ran with them on the Rising Suns. I was older. Okay. But when he would run behind you, he would put on his sweatsuit. Tell him what the sweatsuit looked like. Tell him about the sweatsuit.
I don't remember the sweatsuit. The
shoes and the sweatsuit looked like it was something that came out of trash.
He had them old cookouts. The
first words he would do, he'd blow the whistle. He'd say, get out! Yeah. I want you to spike you! Get out! Am I lying, Jamal? He right behind you. And the thing is, he was about 40 something.
Like
50. Strong, but
yeah,
strong.
He's 50 years old. Jamal
Nigerian
was
strong. Yeah. I'm messing with Nigeria.
Yeah. Jamal was 15 years old. He's running beside Jamal, and he's actually the fastest 15 year old in the country, and he's running beside Jamal.
Wow.
Say, am I lying?
Yeah, he was running like 7'10".
Yes. He was running right beside him, telling him get out and talking to him as he's running. I mean, when I say running, you got to understand, you running behind, beside the fastest 15-year-old, tell him, come on. You do the math. You do the math. That's how fast you
are. I love my.
Yeah. But he was actually a good man to go to that. Like he said, he taught you a lot. And over the years.
His eyes was yellow?
Yeah. But he wasn't yellow. His hands was ashy, though.
Yeah, he did.
But no, all jokes aside, he was a good dude. He was a good man. He taught Jamal a lot, and he actually taught me a lot.
You motherfucker!
But so now transitioning over to after Peoria, when did you decide? What made you want to commit to ASU?
Well, somebody I looked up to in high school, which is Keegan, who went to Peoria also.
Okay.
Shout out Keegan.
Went to ASU. Mm-hmm. My cousin TJ ended up going to ASU.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to play with them, so.
I made
my decision over there.
Okay.
TJ who? TJ Simpson?
Yeah, TJ Simpson.
Oh, I played Pop Warner with him.
Yeah.
You played Pop Warner with TJ Simpson?
Yes. Yeah. Me and TJ, every Friday.
That's why you need right there.
You played Pop Warner. Listen, yeah, all the years I played Pop Warner, me and TJ was on the same team.
What position you play?
When I played Pop Warner, I played wide receiver.
The nigga playing. Yeah, I just remember holding the ball and taking pictures.
No. And Pop Warner, I was terrible in Pop Warner, actually. They made me play wide receiver and cornerback. When I got to high school, I played running back and linebacker. Yeah, hey, that's why I said.
But one thing about it, though, I'll just side. Lonnie Bro, this is what people told me. Lonnie Bravo, they came to me and was like, we jumping Lonnie Bravo now. They said, Lonnie B is your cousin? I was like, yeah, they said, man, he'll fight anybody. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you messing with the wrong one.
Hey, hold on. I almost fought Lonnie Bravo homeboy the other night, man. It was a sad story. I ain't gonna lie to you, man.
My life was probably centered around altercations. That's how niggas remember that time we was about to fight.
Okay, so we get back to Mr. Everything. Right.
Yeah,
so once you committed to ASU, your first practice at ASU, how was that? The very first practice you step on campus, how was that?
I was a little bit nervous, you know, going against all the people. We had people on our team that was about 26 years old. I'm 18.
That's a big jump.
All right.
So you telling me niggas my age? Hold up. I'm 27. You telling me this niggas my age out there?
Yeah.
But still holding on to hope?
But you got to understand, you got your red shirt here, your gray shirt here, and something didn't work out. So it's stuff that didn't work out. Like if you're a red shirt, you could be a 26-year-old freshman, depending how your situation went. You could be either gray shirt with it. What other
shirt? You're a 26-year-old freshman.
Red shirt, you could also go different routes and just come back to school later and want to play ball.
Yeah,
let you play ball.
Hey, I'm cool with empowerment and all that, but if you're 26 trying to go barely to college to play sports, I'm going to talk to you.
Hey, but listen.
Go have some kids.
Hey, I'm going to speak on this. I'm going to say, I had a 50-year-old running back. His name was Benjamin Button. No, not Benjamin Button. Sorry.
That's a movie.
I'm sorry. Hold on. His name was...
Wait. That's a movie.
Benjamin.
Listen. I was like, hold on.
Hold on.
We always that way. Hold on, man.
name was actually, sorry, all jokes aside, his name was actually Benjamin Jackson. You could look him up, Western New Mexico University.
He was 50?
He was 50.
He had his AARP card playing running back.
He was 50. Listen, I could not lie to you. You could look it up. Google this. Benjamin Jackson. Yeah, he got it. No, he played at the last minute when it was like 50 seconds left. You know, I'll never forget the play. He got up.
Responsibility.
Yeah, yeah, he got, the nigga got hit and took him 3 years to get up. The nigga, this nigga came to practice with every pad you could have. This nigga came with elbow pads, knee pads, neck brace. I mean, I didn't even know they made neck braces. You know, but to the moral of the story is, at the, I think my senior year, I told him I respected him just for him to do it. Most people wouldn't even take that chance. Yeah. Then he told me that some stuff happened in his life that he wanted to live out his dream.
You're
so,
a better man than me.
Yeah. Yeah. Nah, but
you would have clowned this nigga. I would have roasted this nigga's dreams like a marshmallow in the fire. I would have hurt this man's feelings all the way. I ain't got time for the crap. All
right, hold on. We getting distracted. We getting distracted. Dream. Let's make sure we...
Okay, so go on. We back on Jamal, so we go edit everything.
Nah,
so
yeah, keep it. Keep first off, everything. We about to drink some of this Remy.
All right.
For those of y'all that subscribe, make sure y'all watch the video podcast on YouTube.
We got some more questions for him though coming up.
Oh yeah.
He was actually on about ASU your freshman year. How was it? You said it was kind of difficult going against guys 26 years old. Mm-hmm. So when was the transition that you actually got it? Like, you know, I belong here.
Caught that nigga and say
you
belong here.
Nah, I would say freshman year.
Oh, so freshman year, you feel like you caught on.
Yeah.
Didn't you almost take one back versus USC or USCLA freshman year?
Oh, no.
Oh, man, I took so many back.
Hey, what else he take back? That's
just being in practice, going against our first team defense, me being on a scout team first half of the season. Just built a lot of my confidence because, you know, going against them and being successful, going against them, just built my confidence up.
Okay. You said I can hang with these.
Yeah, they're 26.
I can hang with these niggas.
Basically. So did you play, so your freshman year, you actually played for Coach Cutter, correct?
No, Erickson.
Erickson. So how was it, you know, the Miami mentality coming from the U? What was his mentality with coaching you guys? Was it easy to connect with or was it kind of difficult to... Get on the same page.
It was pretty easy to connect with Coach Erickson. He was a players coach, and you know, he always did anything for the players and was always there for us. So
yeah, okay. So now I gotta ask you this question. We've been wanting to ask you, Malcolm, LB, the Ghost, and Jay. What was it like? And you already know I'm not gonna say a name, I'm gonna let you answer this. What was it like playing with a, I ain't gonna call him a psychopath, but the craziest dude on the squad? That nigga was crazy. Who I'm talking about? You know who I'm talking about.
Yeah, shout out Vontaze. But, you know, it's always good having that person on your team. Yeah. You always want him to be on your team, not on the other side.
Yeah.
Hey, he's a good person outside of football, but once he step on that field, it's all business.
It's all business. So, hey, but I know you and him had a good connection. Like, do you guys still talk? Stay in touch with each other?
No, I haven't talked to him much since he left ASU.
Oh, okay, okay. Okay.
Well, we have much connection.
So now, going from your freshman year to your senior year, what was the difference?
You said what?
What was the difference going from your freshman year at ASU to your senior year at ASU?
Going into my senior year from freshman year was just the confidence, really.
Mm-hmm.
Coming off my junior year, being successful, being the only person in the nation to score in all categories. Mm. You know, just
he just shined on us real quick. Hold on, he just shined on us very slowly.
He
said, "What'd you say? Say that one more time, Jamal."
Yeah, I said being the only person in the nation to score in all categories.
The only person in the nation to score a passing touchdown, a rushing touchdown, a receiving touchdown, a kick return touchdown, and a punt return touchdown.
Yeah.
Okay.
They ain't call him Mr. Everything for a reason. So, who actually, do you remember the commentator that gave you the name Mr. Everything?
No, I actually don't remember. I just remember seeing a little picture on my Facebook because I think my mom took a picture of it.
So, what was that feeling like, you know, far as, you know, you one of the top athletes at ASU, your mom sending you a picture and everyone calling you friends, family coming to the game. for them to start calling you Mr. Everything? Did a lot come with that title? Was it a lot of responsibility? Was it easy just transitioning over? What was it like?
And I just take it like I did every other day, you know, just kept going.
Hold on. That's Jay Mula in the building. He asked Jamal, why you so humble, man? You was out here shining on these.
Man, I would have been on campus, chest out, all the home.
Acting like Deion Sanders.
I would have went to the NFL office with my conference.
Prime time.
The nigga didn't even finish his freshman year. Talking about NFL conference.
Hey, downtown trying to change your name to Willie Beam.
For real, man. Hey, he did a skit, though, with his shirt off, flexing in the mirror.
Everybody want to be that dude, but shoot, my parents raised me different, you know, told me to be humble, so
yeah. Hey, I heard you was from Florida.
I'm from Mary Z, but you know, my family's from Florida. I got, you know, branch out that way.
You didn't live out in Florida for a little bit?
No, I just lived out there for when I got picked up free agent by the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Yes, sir.
That's
where
we from. Well, man.
Shout out to Florida. That's what I'm going into.
Shout out to Jacksonville. 305 in the building.
Family First is a Miami, Florida movement. You understand? Yes, we Arizona residents, but we do originate from Miami, Florida. You understand? Yeah, so California, that's what I shout. Shout out to
California in the building. Jay Mula.
Shout out everybody.
Kansas City, San Diego. Also shout out to High Def Entertainment. Huntington Dupree couldn't be here. He actually in service.
Gary Dupree.
Big G is Family First. That's all family.
Jamal, you got to keep rocking, man. You meet everybody.
Can I say something real quick? I really don't know Jamal too much, just from the streets, whatever. Not the streets, but just from, you know, party, whatever, and athlete stuff. I remember we had a party. What year was it when we had that party? Right here across the street.
Oh, that was like 2010.
We had a party. 2010.
Oh, Jamal was a super.
I remember. We got Jamal Miles coming through shooting all his boys. But we was geek, bro. We thought we was mad. Just off the street.
Just off his name.
Them niggas was in there trying to pull out of.
Man, I was sending messages saying, but we got Jamal Miles. You know who that is from ASU, right?
Yeah, they started early promoting Jay Mula. Jay Mula was promoting before any nigga
said that. In all good fun. Say that party.
I always had a good time.
It was wild. It was a lot of people.
All right, so going for that. Also, we got Jay in the back. Jay in the back here. Would you say
we got Jay?
You can introduce him when he gets ready to come on. We're gonna have to stop pretty soon. So,
One question.
Actually, yeah, I got one question to ask you before we stop. And the only reason why we gotta stop is because two mics stopped recording. But that's why I moved that mic in front of you.
Yeah.
So I want to ask you if there's anything you can say to a senior in high school getting ready to transition into going into playing sports as a freshman and at a university, what would you say to them? What kind of confidence could you give them, or any advice, or just something that you wish somebody would have told you before you went from doing that?
Man, I tell them the same thing everybody told me, but I didn't want to listen to.
What was that?
Hey, you know, when you get there, focus on school, go to class. That's the most important thing.
You should tell that nigga, what's that nigga name that played for the Sixers?
Benjamin Button?
No.
Benjamin Button?
No, what's that nigga?
Benjamin Jackson.
Ben Simmons?
Yeah, that nigga Ben Simmons was like, I only got 1 year.
That's a real nigga, man. I'm here to get this money.
They're like, just go to school. I'm here to get this money.
But the thing is, you got to understand these athletes. You got to get education, man. You got to get education.
$1 million.
Get educated after. You can still go to school. You can't go to school playing in the league. You can't enroll in college and get the degree, your master's, being a millionaire.
Came from Australia with that shit, man. To America to play professional basketball. His goal was never to play to go to school.
Well, Ben Simmons got a Range Rover and I'm a Mercedes from experience. And a Bentley and a trust fund and a will. I ain't mad at Ben Simmons.
All right,
get your degree later.
Your final words was just. Yeah. Do it right.
Yeah, just go to school. Like you said, like the money ain't always gonna be there, but the degree will.
Jamal, how much women did you get off this, man? Off of returning kicks?
Let's really be honest.
Let's get to it, bro.
How much play did you get, man?
How much?
I played the fifth.
That's a smart man. That's how you do it.
Somebody could be listening.
All right, man. Hey, I appreciate you.
Nah, nobody listening. We got one listener, and his name Alfred. You don't know Alfred for listening, man.
Thanks for having me.
Alfred want to know how many...
The man plead the fifth, man.
Yeah, he pled the fifth.
Malcolm over there trying to be a lawyer.
I stopped it.
Listen, I appreciate you coming through, letting us pick your brain. Hey, you're going to hang out for a little bit, right? Yeah. All right, cool. We're going to keep it going.
That was good shit.
You
got
to start pulling right.
You ain't fine. No damn body. Greg moves probably in a little bit.
I'm going to turn into Scarface.
Who built this? Me, that's who. Fly, Pelican, fly.
See, here he goes.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, fly.
So anyway, I got a friend. She's a big ASU fan. Her ASU to her is like the Cardinals to me. You know what I mean? Like, she knows every single player. She knows niggas that's on like the practice squad. You know what I mean? So I'm pretty sure she knows who your name is. She knows, she definitely loves Brock Osweiler. So I want you to just give her a shout out for me, just for me being a friend or a friend. Her name's Kaylee Warner. Just shout her out, say what's up, and appreciate her for supporting.
Shout out Kaylee Warner. Keep on being a great fan.
That's major shot there.
We know what you're trying to do. Yeah, we know what you're trying to do.
We know what you're really trying to do.
So now we got a new, you know, we back from a bathroom break because, brother had to use the bathroom, but now I'm feeling more creative, more inspired. For some reason, I can't explain it, but everything is all good. But we got a new guest in the building, a highly successful brother. He's very close to Jamal Miles. You know, they came up together. They went to Peoria together. I believe they played at ASU together for my man got cut, because, you know, but he was nice, though. Don't get me wrong. He just was more into the books, you feel me? But he got cut. You know, Michael Jordan got cut. So you could be Michael Jordan, or you could be that other nigga. You could be Michael Jordan. All right, but nah, in all seriousness aside, man, I seen this man at the same time. He was going to Glendale Community College. I seen him transfer to ASU. I seen him get his associate's degree. I seen him get his bachelor's degree. Mm-hmm. I seen him get his master's degree. All right, this man has been through so many obstacles, and I truly respect this man and all of his endeavors. We got my man, and this is just a nickname, all right? But we got Jay Wood in the house tonight. Say what's up, Jay Wood.
Jay Wood in the building.
Yo, what's going on? What's going on, everybody? You know, family first. Thank you for having me, first and foremost. Definitely thank you for having me. I kind of want to start off by saying this. I see what you guys are doing. I'm definitely enjoying the movement, watching it. Definitely want to contribute any way I can. Thanks for that great introduction as well. Definitely just want to
Much deserved.
Just want to be a role model for everybody, you know, growing up and, you know, through struggles and trial and tribulations through life. Just looking over that and being successful in any way possible, and just giving back to everybody in the community and whatnot. So appreciate you having me.
Well, we glad to have you here with us, man. It's an honor.
Family first, right?
You know, but we got to ask you some questions, man. So you and Jamal, man, when did y'all meet, man?
Man, so we got two different stories. This dude said we met, I think he said my first blast in my practice.
What'd you say, Jamal?
You gotta hold on to him.
No, this is like Pop Horner. Like, he's playing for the
team. He's probably like 10.
What Pop Horner team did y'all play for?
We played for the Panthers, the West Side Panthers.
I played for the Panthers, too.
Now, you know what? I can attest. Lonnie B did play for the Panthers.
All right. Hey,
he got cut.
Hey,
he was at the treehouse.
Hey, he like our Tommy. Man, you ain't working.
Nah, but seriously.
He played for the Panthers.
He did play for the Panthers, and he did his thing for the Panthers. But keep going,
So yeah. Anyways, back to the story. So I think it was this one play, trying to run a sweep and try to trying to score. And, you know, I was captain of the defense at that time, whatnot. And he was trying to get loose out of a tackle, and I came and just cracked him out of the blind side. He would say, he'll tell you. But I remember this because after that, this dude started crying, like on the field, right? Like, he says because he couldn't breathe, but.
He was crying because of adrenaline?
I don't know what it was. But after that, bro, he became the man out of nowhere, bro. So I credit it to that tackle, bro. I don't know.
He created you.
He didn't make me a better player.
Honestly, as a football player, the first time you catch that big, like, when it hits you, right. I ain't trying to look at that again.
You look at that a whole different way, don't you?
Hell nah. When I got hit like that, I walked off the field, went home, prayed to God, read a book, and asked my mom if she still loved me. I was thinking, I was done with football. Don't hit my body. Don't hit my body. I'm cool on that.
Don't hit my body.
R&B singer. Don't hit my body. Yo, I ain't playing. Don't hit me.
Not everybody come from the same cloth. So respect to that and whatnot. But no, he thinks it's from we met more younger than that in these apartments, playing football. Like when he was maybe 9, 8 years old playing football in these apartments.
Orangewood.
Everything.
It was in the hood. That's what got in Phoenix. You know, that's the 59th and Camelback. Anywhere in the West Valley in Phoenix, Glendale. Alfred, if you still listening, anywhere on the west side in Arizona, you know, you then pretty much got to the hood until you get the Buckeye Goodyear. Surprise. You better skip over Glendale. Shout out to Glendale.
So y'all was playing football in the complex?
Yeah. So that was a story, but that's the story he'll tell. But mine is the same thing, practice and whatnot. But pretty much.
Okay, cool. So can you tell us kind of what you do now in your life? How'd you go from your bachelor's? You know, Malcolm talked about you got your associates, your bachelor's. Now you have your master's.
Yeah. So. You know, after he said, you know, after they got cut, he didn't know what to do. I started off at GCC and whatnot. Played football there for a minute, didn't like it. I didn't really, you know, adapt to that environment. So I was like, you know, I might as well go to ASU. Mm-hmm. Everybody knows there, you know. So I went there in my freshman year. I joined a fraternity, shout out Sigma Pi, but, you know, so I got to my freshman year, my sophomore year, I decided to, you know, go on a football team, you know what I mean? That's why I know growing up, you know, I was All-State back in high school. I don't want to say much, but nigga was All-State at corner back in high school.
Go ahead and shine on that one time. Wait, say that one more time for us.
All State.
High school. He took out. You took out Brent Michaels. Did y'all beat Millennium senior year?
Bro, yeah.
So they took out Marquise Flowers, Mike Brown.
Yeah,
what's up? You know, I played against. Wait,
we got another Lonnie Bro. I played against every single Griffin.
Lonnie bro got his neck broke by Everson.
The mama don't even know when he.
She like, did you fight?
Put it like this, Everson. Listen, Everson don't remember him. That's all.
I don't remember me at all. This nigga ran right through me. I hope he don't remember.
Hey, speaking of that, I remember.
You got it all on your
own. Okay.
I remember being spring practice or whatever at ASU. Speaking of Vontaze, bro, this nigga stuck in the back of my head.
Vontaze, you owe him $10,000 right now. We see you signed the new deal. Send it right now.
We're calling your lawyers.
Okay. We need that money, or we're filing a lawsuit, Chapter 13, Section 4.
That's when you know somebody crazy. They just slap you on your head and go about their business.
Vontaze Burfict slapped you on the head.
Bro, so we was doing pursuit drills. And I was running back because, you know, I was trying to get a little bit to the team, whatever. So they pitched me the ball and the defense had to get around me. So what happened was the play before that, I was trying to run slow for this, they got around me. I don't really get the ball, whatever.
What is that?
Yeah, so we had to run the ball, whatever. So they had to do it again. So we got back to the beginning with coaches. he was kind of mad because you know he had to do it again. So this nigga snuck back in my head. I turned around.
That was a good job.
That's not so quick. I had to run my chase.
He turned into Friday and Debo. You want something too? Oh man, no.
Perfect. Hell no.
And that's one you gotta just let go. Like Mike Tyson. And I say Muhammad Ali. They slap your woman, you just gotta let that go.
Yeah,
So after you complete your masters, what do you do now in your career, Phil?
So right now I'm working HR, human resources. I'm a facility recruiter for.
Okay,
so I basically
okay.
do all.
I
the,
need a job.
I do all the.
It's gonna go right
with my people.
Yeah, right.
It's gonna be a lot of battles. And you're talking about they know Jay Wood. I'm pretty sure we homies. I'm quite sure we homies.
So, all seriousness, how long have you been doing that?
So I graduated with my master's this year in April. I got that job a month after that. So I've been there pretty much enjoying the time. Definitely love what I do. I enjoy working there. I want to continue my career path there and continue to move up and try to make a difference in this world by giving back to the people.
Hey, you sound real educated. Yeah,
family first.
You sound real
educated. We all about giving back.
All I heard was, you don't have to rely on sports. For anybody who's listening, you don't have to rely on making it to the big league or being the nigga that's on front of the screen.
Respect.
You know what I mean? Having a backup plan. My man got a backup plan and it seemed like he liked it. So, as long as you don't make it sports, have another plan.
So, the moral of the story is you have two young men, I'm going to actually say men, that both started their career at Peoria High School and went separate directions. One in education, and the other one still, Jamal Miles, is actually signed to the Rattlers, so we're looking forward to that. But they're both good friends. They grew up with each other. How old were you guys? You said 8 or 9.
About 9 years old.
Yeah, so I don't know what story is. You know, you got 3 sides. His truth, his truth, and the lie. Whatever you want to call.
Hey, but they both had successful. Exactly, so, exactly. Shout out Peoria High School. But Coach Clapp. Shout out Coach Clapp again, man. Coach Clapp, man. You a wild boy, man.
Hey, man, we ain't going to talk about that.
I like your style, Coach Clapp.
But I respect Coach Clapp because one thing he let players be himself.
Coach Clapp was a real nigga, dog.
He was proud about that, bro.
We're going to have to
bleep
Coach Clapp.
Everybody know Coach Clapp already. It's too late.
So there you have it. We had which you want to go by. What's your nickname? Your alias.
Everybody gotta have a nickname, right?
Yeah, you gotta.
What's your nickname, baby? Jay Wood.
Yeah.
Jay Wood in the building. You see, he asked a couple questions about how him and Jamal met and how they same career. I mean, they started at Peoria and went different directions, but still, they still tight for this day. So we glad to have you, Jay Wood. He's another man to show education is first.
Hey, shout out to Malcolm for always being there, though. Like, do all my success, my accomplishments, though.
Talk to him.
He always come through.
Talk about MX Dub, man.
Hey, man, he a real one, man. Even though it's taken 5 times to actually come through, when he say he coming through, it's always good because he come through for the most important shit, though. He never missed the most important shit. For my engagements and my graduations, it's my being the first person to come to my house, my new built home. He's been a real one. He's holding it down. So definitely shout out to Malcolm and MX Dub for that, and I appreciate you, big homie.
Hey,
I try, man. You know I try, man. I got love for my African brethren. You feel me? Now, I'm joking. I love, man. Real recognized, real at the end of the day. You feel me? I can look at you in your eyes and kind of dictate where your energy is headed towards, man. I ain't never felt bad energy. Well, honestly, nobody around this table. You feel me? So we keep it pushing like that. We keeping the family first. That's why we say family first. And that's just what it is. You family. Everybody here is family. It's just
that. Jay Wood, get your family first. Jay Wood, I'm sorry to say it again. Jay Wood, let us know what it is.
So as you said before, family first. Was first and foremost. Man, shout out to this big dog right here. Big doing big things, man. Still, from when he was little till now. I knew he was going to make it one day. We're still working towards that goal, so.
Okay, I got to hear one thing before y'all go. I'm sorry. We already told everybody y'all's mom. What is the craziest thing both of y'all experienced together?
I'm a professional, so I'm going to keep it at that. That's it for the day.
Y'all,
respect, but you can't be mad. You got a run for mayor, no matter what.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, you got to run for mayor. You know
that combo we had?
Yeah, you never know.
Also, Jay Wood just threw another accomplishment. He's going to go reach, running for mayor. I was playing.
Another shine moment.
Another shine moment. He just shined on me. He made me want to go back to school. I'm singing Mace in my head, right? I mean, Nas. I know I can.
You know I'm an ill nigga. All I know is the street. All
right. Yeah. So hold up.
I was born by the stop sign. Stop sign.
So now that. Are y'all ready?
Yeah, we've been ready.
All right, so this section of it is probably going to be my favorite part just because I'm always on Instagram. I don't know. What do y'all do in y'all free time? When you ain't doing nothing
on Instagram.
Who be scrolling? Y'all be scrolling?
I scroll.
Who be some scrollers?
I scroll. All
right.
I get to scrolling at the room and my girl be coming.
Yeah.
And why is Shy texting me at 3 in the morning?
I make the bed. I take out the trash.
But actually, my favorite thing I've been following lately is Soulja Boy and Chris Brown.
Oh, man.
That's some funny shit, right?
That's comedy, bro. That's comedy.
Soulja! I got Chris Brown.
Soulja. Yeah, no, hold up. Soulja. I didn't even ask the question yet.
Okay.
This nigga fully. Well, we know who you got.
Mm-hmm.
But really.
Preach.
Who do you got? Soulja Boy, Chris Brown. I got to hear it now.
State and, your name.
Yeah, say your name before you, because they can't see us. So.
All right, take your time. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Well, it's me. It's Lonnie B. I got Chris Brown, man.
Why?
Because that nigga, I don't know. That nigga died and stumped the yard. I feel like
he gonna come back revenge.
Yeah. No, honestly, man, I watched both videos where both of them looked like they was training, and Soulja Boy looked like he was training at daycare. You know what I mean? And Chris Brown, I saw, like, he didn't look like a professional boxer, but he actually looked like he had some
footwork out there.
Yeah.
He had some lateral.
Yeah, he was Soulja Boy was fighting himself. He was throwing wide punches. Like, I really didn't understand.
Okay, one for Chris Brees.
Yeah, so I'm taking Chris Brown.
This J-Fell, a.k.a. J-Diddy, Joshua. I'm going to go for Chris Brown. Reason why I say Chris Brown, I'm going to say this. A man that can dance like that, he can move. He light on his feet. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's all. I'm going to go with Chris Breezy, because the way he moved, because he danced. No homo, but Chris, CB. CB, that's Jay Phelps.
It's two for CB.
Yeah. Okay. AKA Ghost, I'm going to go with Chris Brown.
Yeah?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, definitely. I think Soulja Boy tells stories too good. Nigga can tell stories too good.
Hey, that nigga been telling the coolest stories.
His story too good. He honestly, with his story.
Honestly, if we didn't see the fight and Soulja Boy told the story.
Story, bro. Yeah.
You'd believe he won.
Yeah.
You'd be like, this nigga's bad.
He's like, oh, so Chris was crumping, right? And I hit him with an uppercut. Pow!
They say Soulja ain't good in the hood.
Yeah.
I go. That's all right. Malcolm.
So, Malcolm, how you feel?
I'm riding with Soulja. Oh,
for real?
Oh, man.
Hold up.
Why?
Why?
Because he dark skinned, nigga.
Tell me how good.
Number two, because, man,
it's
Chris
about
Brown.
Taking it off for dark skin.
I'll tell you the truth of the matter. Whether Chris Brown win or lose, I'm going to look at him. And I actually love CB. I think he almost, he ain't the king of R&B, but he the prince. R. Kelly would
definitely
be the king, but. But I ride with CB, but I'm just saying, Soulja, I feel like Chris Brown in the room. Like,
why?
Why
like,
is he in the room?
Because he acting like a hoe. Over a
they
hoe.
Both acting like a
what?
Hoe.
What?
They over a hoe. Nah, but Chris Brown doing it over a hoe. Soulja Boy acting like a hoe over a reaction.
Chris Brown the one fighting over a girl. If you really dig deep,
truth. You know what? I appreciate you standing up against the majority.
Nah, hey, that's just my take.
We gotta I'm go just to, telling you. Okay, Jay Wood. We heard Malcolm Peace. We got here Jay Wood. Who you going for? Soldier or Chris Brown?
I gotta go with the man with the Draco. Oh,
that Draco, nigga.
You know, anybody got a Draco like that, it's the... banging it on social media and live and whatnot. I mean, you gotta kind of feel away. You know what I mean? So to be that confident, you know, when you 105 soaking wet, you gotta be some kind of, you know. And I know a lot of skinny, strong dudes, bro. Like, the most skinniest dude be the strongest person on the you know on the block. You
that's
know what
a
mean?
Fact. That's a fact.
Look at how honestly, look at Ti, nigga. That nigga probably what 150 soaking wet.
They got name for that. It's called skinny strong.
Yep.
Bro, so I feel like although he might be uncoordinated, like you're not athletic at all.
Yeah.
Young Draco.
Yeah.
He got some anger behind him, I feel like, and you know, when them bones touch your face,
hey, you make it sound scary, nigga. I might have to switch up. He said, when them bones touch your chin, nigga.
You got weapons?
Like, yeah, hold up. I don't want no bones touching my chin.
Like that, when they sharp like that, like nail down here. Yeah. In a sense, like, if you get, you know, on a slight chance, he get hit with a couple of those going.
I don't know.
But you know what? He had a chance in the hood to show he could fight, bro. And he backed the hell up.
Bro, and that's another reason why. Because when that nigga said, Big Soldier ain't from the hood, that nigga pushed him up off.
Get off me.
Nigga, get off me.
Yeah.
But respect.
Did y'all see the rest of that video though?
Yeah, I saw it. He said,
"Come see playing with Soldier Boy, man." For it,
bro, I saw the rest of the video. He put his phone down. And he was like, "What's up, then?" But then he backed up.
Now I peeped the scoreboard, seen it was a losing score. Talented, sharp black nigga, what the fuck I'm losing for? No, I got a choice, it was time to start choosing more. But more is less in life, a lot of friends have to choose a door. I ain't sad nigga, time just revealed the real. Fuck niggas fall off, real niggas win it still. Nigga wanna shine too? Nigga get your grind on. It's more shit to life than average bitches in an iPhone. More shit to life than a club in a bottle. Need a lead, check me, the nigga use your follow. Something like an architect, a man with a plan. Something like a quarterback, I'm calling all the plays. Run the right route or you getting out the game. Fuck around and make me kick a nigga off the team. I done turned winning to a habit.
Undefeated.
Nowadays, I just see it, then I grab it. It make my worries disappear like magic.
Harry Potter.
Trying to get it any way that I can have it. I done turned winning to a habit.
It's a habit.
Nowadays, I just see it, then I grab it. It make my worries disappear like magic.
Yeah.
Trying to get it any way that I can have it.
Got me creeping on the come up, bone thugs. You wanted problems, well, you fucking with the wrong one. Fucking up your good day, turn it to a long one. You better have your